I mean, they said that's where you came from, so probably a safe assumption. There's gonna be enemies here. With how wide open this is. Yeah, no doubt.
Would benefit from antilopany morphologies, though capric forms show superior load-bearing capability.
You're a quick study, Gaia.
Dr. Sobek, as I have conducted this comparative analysis of mammalian morphologies, I've gathered extensive data on the quaternary extinction event.
Oh? And your assessment? Gaia?
Logically speaking, the extinction was a natural consequence.
And yet,
I find the loss of megafaunal species that they passed forever.
So the AI is getting sad. I don't know how I feel about that.
Should have brought a cart.
Oh, what am I getting stuck on? A chair. Goddamn chairs.
The Alpha Registry master file.
Intact?
Yeah. No signs of corruption.
Then what are you waiting for? Copy the file.
With this, I can restore the registry at the hatch inside Allmother. Open it. Go inside.
And grasp the secrets within.
Where I was born. Maybe. Maybe who gave birth to me.
Who? Are you really so naive? There will be no who waiting for you there, Aloy. Whatever birthed you into the world was a what, not a who.
You bastard.
Oh no, I had a legitimate birth. It's you, Aloy, who are the creation of a machine. But what kind of machine and why? Why were you created?
Eclipse.
You need to get out of there. What you found is too valuable. You're too valuable.
Oh, they see us.
For you, child. My entire life, I've always known one thing with prophetic certainty, that I was destined for glory as a great champion of the sun. Even when Jaron was murdered, even when Meridian fell, I never doubted my destiny. Until you came along. When I heard that you had survived, a doubt took root in my mind. As sure as the sun rises and falls each day, those I am bade to kill die. And yet I failed. How? Why? With each dig site you attacked, each loyal soldier you killed, this pestering doubt grew. I kept thinking of the moment my knife pierced your throat. One twist, a simple tug of the blade, and you would have bled out. In slaughter, I am a practiced hand. So why hesitate? Why fail my destined purpose?
See that scar on your cheek? You didn't get to finish.
Yes, I remember. He fought well. For a savage.
His name was Rost, and he was a better man than you could ever hope to be.
The better man is the one who doesn't end up with his guts steaming on the ground. No. It wasn't him. I could have finished you before he attacked. But I didn't. This failing troubled my thoughts. Haunted every step. It was only when I captured you, down in that place, that I finally glimpsed the sun's design etched at length across the course of events. You were meant to survive that day on the mountain. Meant to interfere at dig sites and kill my men. Conversely, I was meant to capture you. Here. So that you might die as a sacrificial offering to the sun. Everything as it was meant to be. Predestined and preordained.
Some destiny. You're following orders, not some grand cosmic design. You're a puppet, with Hades yanking the strings. A pawn pushed around by larger forces. It'd be laughable if there weren't so much killing involved. Hades is an ancient machine, not the buried shadow of Karja myth. It doesn't care about Meridian. It wants to kill everything and everyone. And you are its dutiful slave.
I serve not the buried shadow, but the sun in shadow. All halves of nature joined to one cause. Shadow to sun, dark to light.
Do you really not hear how ridiculous that sounds? You've gone from serving an insane homicidal sun king to an insane homicidal machine. You're moving down in the world, not up.
I'll remember those words as I watch your corpse burn. Whatever's left of it. You fail to grasp the point. As surely as you've been conquered, so has all doubt. And with certainty of belief comes unstoppable force.
Then get this cage and put your faith to the test. See if things work out like you expect.
The circle has closed. Every element is in its proper place, exactly where it belongs. The errant beast, now caged, will serve her true purpose. A sacrificial animal. Oh, speaking of sacrifice, I forgot to tell you. After you crashed the Eclipse Network, I sent messengers into the east to rally the forces there and mount an invasion of the sacred land. I ordered every Nora killed. I was hoping to catch you there, but alas, it all seems to have been unnecessary.
Why butcher dozens of innocents for no gain? It's a waste of effort.
You're right. I won't even be there to enjoy it. In any case, I couldn't recall the order even if I wished to. Thanks to your destruction of the network, communication over distances is impossible. You not only doomed yourself, but an entire tribe. Do we not see the scorching judgment of the sun in these events? Your focus, such a powerful device, isn't it? And yet, so fragile. So you see, this time, I did not hesitate. The knife has already been twisted.
Faithful, rejoice! Our years in shadow are over. A new dawn trembles on the horizon. A new day, soon to break. And when it does, the false Sun King will be dead, and Holy Meridian ours once more. In this, I have become an instrument of prophecy. All halves of nature joined to one cause. Shadow to sun, light to dark, night to day. Behold!
Is that the doctor?
Hold your seats! Can you not see the proof of the sun's blessing before your eyes? How else could shadows such as these prowl in broad light of day? Were they not approved by the sun and joined to our cause? Many years ago, to consecrate this great ring, the Radiant Juron ordered many faithless crushed beneath the hooves of the behemoth. Mighty is the behemoth in the eyes of the sun, but it is mightier still, infused with the power of shadows. Let this one, who schemed and slithered, be the first to die. Let her be the first of thousands.
Another hit, and that pillar will come down.
Hold up. Oh, never mind. I'm not available.
That did it. One more pillar, and that platform will come down. And my weapon's with it.
Really, though? I gotta use up all of my health.
Getting ready to charge.
Hit him with that disrespect. What's up, bitch?
Silence!
Flip him off. Just hit him with the flip him off. Be like, is that all you got, you little bitch? Fight me like a man.
Kill her.
So wait, am I not gonna be able to do side quests after this? Like, did I fuck up and have to like play through all of this again? Because this took me a lot longer than I expected. Never mind.
So you're here. Really here. You risked your life.
Of course I did. If you'd been killed, the Nora Sacred Mountain would never have given up its secrets.
Too bad you wasted your time, then. Helis destroyed my focus, and the Alpha Registry with it.
Not at all. The whole time I've been monitoring your focus, I duplicated every data file you scanned. Installing that data to a new focus was trivial and easy. Happy birthday, Isaac. Daddy sure does love his little big man.
You're really good at making it impossible to like you, Silence. But I guess I need this.
It's time to see where you were born. Maybe you'll even learn why.
Yeah. Meet the machine that birthed me into this world. Isn't that how you put it?
I'll be off.
Wait.
Yes?
Helis recognized you back in the Sun Ring. You told me that you'd assisted the Eclipse. Not that you knew the man who killed my... who almost killed me.
So now you know. The man is a serious threat. So let's do all we can to make sure that he and Hades don't succeed.
Right. Since when can you override machines?
Ever since you discovered the technique. I had to destroy a corruptor to obtain the necessary parts, of course. But your example showed me how to do that as well. Yet another benefit of monitoring your activities through your focus. Truth be told, the underlying logic of the technique isn't so different from rites practiced by Banuk shamans, though, of course, far more advanced.
Great. You're welcome, I guess. How did you track my location when I wasn't wearing a focus?
Really, Aloy? It doesn't take a genius to surmise that Helis would throw you into the Sun Ring at high noon. I wore out 2 striders getting here in time, but I did. Now be on your way.
I'll be on my way. To make matters worse, Helis ordered an Eclipse detachment to attack the Nora Sacred Land. The tribe's already weak. They won't stand a chance. You should come with me.
Well, absolutely not. I have preparations to make elsewhere.
What kind of... Why do I bother asking? You're not gonna tell me.
When the time is right, I'll be in touch. I'll contact you later. In the meantime, should you need to return to Shadow Carja territory, I brought armor to conceal your identity.
You think of everything, don't you?
One of us has to. Aloy, when you were recovering the Alpha Registry down in the Zero Dawn bunker, I was needlessly cruel. For your sake? I hope there is someone waiting there for you inside the mountain. Not a what, but a who. Yeah!
Alright. That was, I feel like that quest wasn't even, like, ridiculously long either. Okay, so yeah, that's Traitor's Bounty. That's a side quest I was talking about that unlocks. So that's these are so this will lead. This is one of the last two errands, and then the next one will unlock. And then the only other side quest, I believe, is like, you know, down here is where I think it is. But yeah, we're gonna, while we're here, we're gonna get the bandage and metal flower. And that way we don't have to come back up here for anything. Vantage point is up here.
Whoa there.
And you know, I actually came out of that, like, doing okay, material-wise. So that's good. And and I looked it up, and point of no return, basically it just means that you can't leave during the quest. You have to beat it start to finish. So apparently that's what they meant by point of no return. And not like, hey, this is near the end of the game. You know, if you don't have everything done, tough shit. Ah. Eat up. Eat up.
Might need that.
Vantage, is the vantage point up here? That'd be my guess. Oh, shit. Up here. Why were they up here? I think that's the better question. Like, how'd they get stuck up here? Alright, there's only two more vantage points. Now, let's go over here to this metal flower. And collectible-wise, are we done up here in the top of the map? Nope, we got two more collectibles up here at the top. I'll probably fast travel there and get the Banook figure. And then I still need to do those. I'll probably do that like right before. Alright, so that's going to be over there. I need to hop down. See, but like the thing that sucks is I want to get the armor just to make the game easier, but it's not unlocked until the very end when realistically it probably doesn't even matter. So I think like my main goal is like get the collectibles, get the armor. Look around for the flower. Can't grab that, so I'm assuming it's not up there. Oh, wait a minute. I spy with my little eye climbable ledges. Which means the flower is up there. Yeah, I need to finish off the collectibles. But I'm getting closer and closer.
Metal flowers.
Six more flowers. Wait, hold up. So, two more vantage points. Six more flowers, and the last Banook figure. So, we gonna mark this, and then I think fast traveling here will probably be quickest. Then the metal flower there, and there. Which I don't really have any quick places. And the last vanish down there. Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and get the rest of the collectibles now, especially since I'm so close. I think that sounds pretty good. I've only been recording for an hour and 30 minutes. So hopefully within the next 30 minutes I can manage to get the rest of the collectibles. I think that would be a good goal. And then after that, I can finish off the last of the side quests, except for, you know, the very last one, which would be the armor. Oh wait, nope, that's not where I need to go. The Banuk figure. Goddammit, there's a flying enemy too. I'm at the point where I'm just like so done with the flying enemies. They're anti-fun.
Stocking up.
So climb up these. I'm assuming it's gonna be up on top of this mountain. Now the real question is, can I get up there without being spotted by the dumbass birds? Which my assumption would be probably not. Okay, so that's where the drop-off point is. Missed 4 arrows. 5 arrows. There we go. Dude, I swear to God, dude. Oh my God. See, this is why combat sucks so much against the birds. Okay, if that's the only bird though, I'll be happy. I spent so many fucking arrows on that bullshit. I think I see. See, I'm not seeing anything that's climbable is the issue. Yeah, it's like none of this is climbable. Ow. I didn't mean to do that. Yeah, I'm not seeing any of this climbable. Maybe I can get up over here, maybe? But I'm pretty sure this is not like the correct way to go. Like, it's sometimes you can see them, other times you can't. It depends on what type of rock it is. They definitely could have made the ledges more visible though.